all these strangers. Everywhere is danger. This anger.
I'm great, man. Thanks for having me.
Hating everyone that I see.
Well, first off, we're delighted to be back. We love the culture, the energy that you get when you're in France, when you're in Paris. For me, it's a beautiful thing to be here. I mean, on the memory side of things, coming to this venue last time, it was POD and then Hell Yeah. And Vinnie Paul from the Almighty Pantera, that was his other band. And it just brought back memories of hanging out with him. Rest in peace, Vinnie Paul, you know, and that whole tour 6 years ago together. And now he's in the heavens, man. But it's a little sentimental for me in that sense, because a good friend of ours is no longer with us, but we played this venue together. So there's like, oh man, you know. So other than that, to hear that the show sold out and, you know, that the French people are coming out to see some Southern California rock and roll, us from San Diego, Alien Ant Farm from Riverside, which is an hour north of San Diego, and we're bringing a little bit of the Southern California style to your city and your country, and we're glad that some people want to see it, so we're excited. It's been a good response. A lot of people that like the Satellite album like the Circles album. They think that it has some familiarity, and we didn't do it because of that. We like to write music. We're selfish. We like to write music that we like first. When you're in an industry where you have people, executives with ties and suits, corporations, this is what's going on right now. This is what's hot. You guys need to do this. We've always been the band that's like, nah, we do what we like. We do what we want to hear, because we're the ones that have to go play it around the world. So why would you write music that you hate? Like, I hate this song, man. So everything that you hear, we love, because we wrote that from our heart and soul, man. So whether people like it, hate it, love it, that's awesome, but we're glad that you like it, but we have to like it first. Well, I mean, rock and roll is definitely a guitar-driven sound. So as the guitar player of the band, I take on a lot of the responsibility when it comes to writing riffs or chord progressions. I don't ever come to the band and say, I wrote the whole song, here it is, because there's no energy there. I'd rather go like, hey man, I got a couple parts, let's jam and let's see what they feel like, let's see how they feel as a band. And then sometimes we'll start jamming, that's cool, or that's badass, man, let's keep jamming, why don't we try this? And you know, it kind of evolves. But if I don't do my homework, then we go into the jam room and it's just a jam session. It's like, well, I don't have any, let's just play. And sometimes that works, but I still have to do my homework. Hey, I got these parts, man. Let's see if we can make something out of it. So, and then Sonny does a lot of the writing on the vocals and melodies, but he'll throw ideas back and forth with us. If he's stuck, hey man, what do you think of this? Or I'll say, hey man, when I wrote that guitar progression, that chorus, I was thinking this, I was thinking that, and then he takes it and we kind of feed off of each other. Well, I mean, it's only been a year. I mean, we're always writing new music. I wouldn't say that we've started focusing on writing a new album quite yet, because, you know, there's a lot of markets that we haven't hit. Touring wise, and we've made a conscious decision as a band to be a worldwide band, not just, oh, we're just gonna play in America and that's it. No, man, we play Latin America, we play Europe, we'll play Australia, we'll play Asia, and that's because we have fans all over the world and we gotta feed them. They're like seeds, you gotta put some water on there, put some sunlight, let them grow. So, you know, you put your best foot forward when you record new music and you want everybody to hear it. And like tonight, we'll play like 6 or 7 new songs. You know, we're not a cover band. We're not gonna sit and come and just play the stuff off our old records. We're gonna play some new material because we're proud of it. I listen to everything, man. For me, what inspires me is music that has soul. And what I mean by that is, I'm not talking like James Brown soul, like woohoo. Like, I'm talking about music that you can feel like, damn, man, that got me. Like, I don't care what style it is. It could be pop, it could be electro. As long as if something feels good to me, I'm like, I love that song. It feels great. So it's a big vibrations, feelings for me. right now, I've been listening a lot to the latest Cascade. Which is like an EDM electronic. And as a guitar player, I've always listened to more alternative electronic music because of all the atmospheric things that you hear in the sounds. So as a guitar player, I say, dude, that'd be kind of cool. What if I could try to make something similar but on guitar? You know, delays and echoes and, you know. And I try to incorporate that in my style and in my music. And a lot of these guys, that when I was on Ozfest touring with different metal players, a lot of the guys, I mean, I'm not saying no names, but a lot of people have tunnel vision. I only listen to metal. I only listen to this, hip hop or whatever. For me, it's like, I want to grow, man. I want to feel. I want to touch. I want to take on what the life has to give. So I try to incorporate that as a rock guitar player. So a lot of people say, well, dude, look, even back then on Youth of the Nation, how did you come up with that? And I'm like, that was, I mean, not cocky or not overconfident. It was natural, man, because it came from here. You know, it was just more about the sound than it was the complexity of the riff or the complexity of the technicality of shredding. Man, one note sometimes, bang, ding, ding, ding. That note, no matter where I go, China, Mexico, they speak English or not. As soon as you hit that note, everybody knows. I don't care how old the song is. That's a universal song now. And I'm proud of stuff like that, man. And that's the goal. We're definitely planning on coming back 2020, do the festivals in the summer. The one that is confirmed is Grass Pop in Belgium, and then Download Fest in the UK. We keep hearing we're going to do Hellfest. I don't know if it's confirmed yet. We would love to do it. We had a great time. The crowd got crazy. I don't know if you guys were there when we played, but the whole crowd went to the ground during Southtown. And then as soon as we exploded, the whole crowd jumped. And when they went down to the ground, there was a guy dressed as Jesus. And he was standing up by himself in the middle of the crowd. So that's what we remember about that show. It was like, that was fun, man. That was crazy. Thousands of French going off, man. And, you know, we would love to come back to Hellfest. And we keep hearing, like, you know, the different festivals. I don't even know what's a festival anymore, you know? Like, we did Nova Rock in Austria, and I don't know if that's a festival, but we're trying to do as many festivals as we can. So hopefully, fingers crossed. Well, here's the thing. America is very, done, gone. Like, they go by fads real quick. With all types of music, hip hop, And, you know, you have your loyal fans. We have our loyal fans in the U.S. But it's always about the next the next new thing. Where around the world, if fans love your band, they love a band, they, like, love a band. Like that's the difference. Like, America can be a little pretentious. But the fans that we have, thank God, like, they're all been really good to us. It just seems a little more enthusiastic. You'll have a line, sold out crowd in America, but everyone's like more like a friend now. Like, hey, Marcos, hey. You go to South America, it's like you're the Beatles. You know, like, yeah. You're like, what the, you know, my hat. And he's like, hey, man, get my, you know. And it's funny, but dude, people are fanatics in different ways. And I think that Western civilization with America, people just got a little spoiled. They're just used to, you know, it's another band. You know, it's hard to get excited for anything. So, I think over here in Europe, it's just, for us at least, people really appreciate a band continuing with the same band members and continuing to see us grow as musicians. You know, and I would like to think that some bands, they grow and they change members and the sound change and they kind of went like, I don't know. I feel that we've been pretty consistent at staying true to our roots within regards to our culture, our where we're from, our style. And I think that's helped us a lot. It's awesome. I think it's good. It's good for music. It's good for the industry, especially a band like that or a band like Radiohead or a band like Tool. They don't give a fuck. Like, and I love that about art, because what happens is so many artists are trying to kiss corporations' ass. Play my music, please. You know, these bands come in and say, you want to come or not? We're gonna be Rage Against the Machine. I don't care, and people are gonna come. You gotta admire that, man. That is the place you wanna be as an artist, as a musician. And I think it's awesome. Same thing. I like emo music. I like a couple songs, but it doesn't have the same validity or energy than the Rage thing for me. It's two different. It's apples and oranges. I prefer the apple. Style-wise, attitude-wise, energy-wise. You know nothing about Zach De La Roca. He disappeared. And then he just comes back in and he's just gonna fucking... Right? That's powerful to me, man. Well, I'm gonna lean more towards Rage Against the Machine. For sure, man. I mean, stylistic-wise, Southern California, all that stuff, man. We're from the streets of L.A., we're from the streets of San Diego. It's like 2 hours south, right on the border of Mexico. You know what I mean? So it's all that, man. The struggle. And, you know, you guys have your own struggles. Yesterday, you guys have your riots and your street protests. It's a beautiful thing that you can do that in your country. Because in other countries, they'll kill you. You might get beat down here or in the States, but at least you get to say something. It's usually you're fighting with another citizen that doesn't agree with you. Conservative, liberal. And then the cops come and stop! You know what I'm saying? But at least you're able to do that. Agree to disagree. Well, I know both of bands They're both friends of ours. But I'd have to lean more towards Korn. Reason being is because Korn is the first band ever take POD to Europe. On the Issues tour, we had just put out Fundamental Elements of Southtown and they asked us to be direct support, and that's when Issues was out, so they were playing arenas sold out and it was just us and them. So we get on stage, play for 45 minutes, sold out arena, and they were real fans of our band and we've been friends with them ever since. Sonny's actually really close to Fieldy and Head. They have a little like charity that they do in the US together to help the youth of America. Dead or Alive? A band from this era or a band from the past? That's a tough one. You know what band I really like? They're very musical. Circus Survive. You ever heard of them? One of my favorite bands, like newer bands. They're not that new anymore, but they gave, I like what they do musically. So I would say Interview, Circa, Survive.
It's not, that's right.
Okay, cool.
Thank you very much.
Hey, thank you.